take a look at a portion of scripture here that John took me to. By the way, a lot of that to give you where God wants you to go. Amen. And so don't ever let the devil beat you up. I'm going to turn to Luke chapter 19. And I want to talk about Zacchaeus. Somebody say that. Zacchaeus. What a thing. Right. But that's my guess. Every time I say Zacchaeus, I can think about that as Sunday school. Like Zacchaeus was a weaving man. A weaving man. What he can call that thing. A sick of all three. To see what he could see. Like that. But what's that sound? I think you guys should do something with the earphone that's in the gift to my or plug it here with that. I'm hearing that just sound. I'm talking over with some of you over here. Might be distracted by this. So I looked at this story. I'm just going to read it to you. I'm usually referring to this story in the context of the fact that God is no respecter of persons. We know that Zacchaeus was a tax collector and he was. I'm probably a thief. Everybody had determined to do that about him. But God gave me a different perspective on him because here's what I want you to do. I believe we're living today right now where we as the people of God have the opportunity to rise above the fray in his world and to connect with the God who wants to reach this world. Arise, shine, for thy light is come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. Isaiah 60. It says, for darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people, but the glory of the Lord shall arise upon us. So we must learn how to rise, how to step up. Is that a reason to you? Here we go. Luke chapter 19, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. It's important. You know, sometimes Jesus is passing through a service. And depending on how you reach out to receive is whether or not you receive from him. Now, Daniel was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector. It was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was. But being a short man, he could not because of the crowd. So he went to him and climbed a sycamore tree, fig tree, to see if Jesus was coming this way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, Zacchaeus, come down to me. I must stay at your house today. So he came down at once. It wasn't his father, but it was worth that. All the people saw this and began to cry. God to be a guest of a sinner. But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount. Jesus said to him, today, salvation has come to this man. Now this man too is the son of Abraham. But the son of man came to take the seat. I'm inspired by this. And I said, no, just because God can reach out, but because I believe that we have the opportunity, like Zacchaeus, to do something. We don't have to climb a tree, but we might have to do something that takes effort. You might have to do something that takes effort to move you out of a place where you're at. Zacchaeus is amazing. Now, this man has been a great guest to me. Pure. Innocent. Gracious. You know, a lot of times, you don't realize that when God brought you, Jesus wasn't an intention for you. It wasn't an intention for you to fail. It was intended for you to succeed, for you to be a blessing. You to carry out the purpose of God. Zacchaeus had a purpose of God upon his life. But he was
judged negatively. He was defined negatively by the people around him. He was isolated, probably in life. But we would call it that he was by society. Yet he arose from the crowd and was called out. What we all want. You know, the enemy will do everything that he can to keep us focused on all the distractions. One thing, for the sake of God and the next thing, like it's been said, I've been already this morning, that sin, you know, before the service starts, these distractions. What do we do? Move into the presence and the purpose of God, because it's coming to church today. To connect to the God of the you were conceived by God for such a time as this. You were conceived of God in this time. God is a realm of influence for you in this world today. The enemy will do everything he can to drive and keep you out and keep you away from the mighty power of God. I tell you a few things that what I believe that he is, first of all, he saw a season of unforgiveness. I can tell you, I believe that in general, in the church, as bad as the world might think, we are in a season of opportunity. I think that the Bible says, but seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is there. I believe, I can tell you this in 3 minutes, I preach this way today. The season between sowing and reaping is getting shorter and shorter. The Bible says that this would happen in the last days. But the prophet would catch up with the reaper. I used to say, seeds fly by season and harvest. There's a lot of time between seeds and harvest, but it's getting shorter. And when you get to God, you not just see God is not but the prophet sows that which is absolutely free. It's faster. I'm getting more testimonies that way. And now we're talking about so many free that we often talk about where we're thinking about offering. I'm talking about people that you give. When you give the public show, you know, you minister peace, you minister hope, you minister forgiveness, understanding. It's not like you're a different thing. With regard to offerings, I'm afraid that they probably give an offering, maybe a big offering in service, and before they get to that spot, the spot brings that there's a new commentary from somebody, Jesus, something else. I want to see that one is coming more quickly to people. It's that spot, and I believe that, we're there. I want to remind you of a lot of other situations in the Bible that somebody had to see a season. And they literally, it was kind of a defining moment. I believe that there's an opportunity for a defining moment in each of our lives. You know, this week, one of the things that we can point out, what is it that went to my son Michael's graduation? He got it. Back and forth, and that one the crowd is saying, like, what? You know, he's going to be in the break with all the other players, and he's still going to win that game. That was a moment. It was a season of opportunity. I believe God brings that place to us at various times in our lives. Remember when Peter walked on the water? In the middle of a storm, what was it that caused Peter to say, Lord, make me a sign out of the water? And Jesus just gave one instruction. Come and Peter walked on the water. He saw this season of opportunity. The Hebrew boy, the great Hebrew boy, said, I'm going to go get the fire. Yeah, with the season of opportunity, I mean, they went from being thrown in the fire to being promoted by the king. Because of that, the final moment. It's the end of 6:16, they analyzed it. It seemed bad just to be thrown in the lion's den, but what happened? God saw it through. He got promoted. Also, the people out there running through some of these examples that you're familiar with, David, when he defeated Goliath. I mean, he couldn't even kill. What a gracious moment for the whole nation. But David, there was a spiritual battle going on with him. Yes, it wasn't strength to kill giants. He had a sword of the spirit in himself. It didn't make any earthly sense. But creatively living and creatively thinking, he knew he had a big battle. And somehow, some way, God was going to be a threat. I just thought, I look at this in the context of Ezekiel, because church, we've got to come to a place in our lives if we will not allow our circumstances, our fears, the pandemic, other people's opinions of us. We don't allow anything to define us. But God. Somebody say, but God. I love it when I get the counsel. I think that I just want us to understand that trouble the world from us. God at work doing something for us. God at work. We need to live above the brain. Yes, he is. He needs to do something. We find the truth to get beyond his obstacles and his limitations. We might have to do something as difficult, because I believe that faith requires us to do what we say to do. And what we do, we literally start living in the presence of God. At least this week, you know, to start a message to this way, to have the father of the children, and to the father of the husband, Daniel, who was the one who talked about it, because the bride. By the way, when you talk to church, don't expect to find a greeting with them. They will finish you up. You know what happens is he's looking beyond that. He's climbed the tree. He's looking to the next message for his house. He's looking to see what God has in mind. I love that. We all need to understand this is what God has in mind. When you've got God to free you, you've got everything that you need. The enemy is going to try to get us to this point. We can see with our natural eyes. But God's going to hold the secret of it. God's got a plan. So that he is coming to dream to see Jesus. I'm reminded of another story when Jesus multiplied the little boy's lunch to feed the 5,000.
It might have been 50 cents. He saw the obstacles he was facing. He did something that he couldn't do. And he would have been criticized for it. I mean, Jesus could be stuck. He still would have been criticized for just doing for a degree. Sometimes you got to do something. It shows the kind of desperate you are. That's why we have to praise God. I've said this before. If you do that thing, you could never be wrong. As people of God, people of faith, we need to be willing to take some chances. To get our faith in this, overcome our fears, overcome our doubts, and don't let the world erase those thoughts. I think having so many hearts, chapter 2, where some friends of a paralyzed man were trying to get the message to Jesus. I remember that Jesus was in the presence of so pressed that he couldn't get through the door, couldn't get anything. What did they do? They went on the roof and tore the roof off and lowered him. The kids climbed the roof. They tore the roof apart. The woman bleeds for 12 years. The Bible calls it the woman with the issue of blood. It specifically says, you have to press your way through the crowd. Probably on that tent of knees, trying to reach the top of his blood. And when he touched Jesus, somebody touched him with their faith because they had endurance and effort to overcome the obstacle. The blind man is rejoicing. When Jesus was passing by, he cried out. And the people around him said, be quiet. He's already passed. We don't pass. Something that requires us to do something that allows strength
into the kingdom. That brings a life. A life. Because it's worth the world is trying to divide us. The world is trying to cancel us.
But
look out for us. Because we've got to turn on what is coming. As greater is he that is in me. I'm watching less news. I don't want that news to ever be different. I just turned off and I can't hear that. That's such a wrong perspective that bothers me about the, what's going on in the world now. The way they're calling. The perpetrators, the terrorists, what? Look at that answer of 1,000 rockets have already been launched into Israel. Well, there's something else that are the perpetrators. But we have to do something. What are you doing? What are you doing? But you know what they did? They did something that just so good. And the Bible says, all they went. They had to start out. So many times we did. But the final moment, it has happened because we just said, that can't be done. That can't happen for me. So I don't understand it with my faith. Instead of just saying, I'm doing something different. We come through a pandemic stronger than we were a year ago. Stronger. Thank you. I just want to